Welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Well, yesterday we recorded this macro and I was pretty happy because I used relative references and I got the totals in the right spot. However, take a look at these totals, this little green triangle down here in the lower left-hand corner. That green triangle, usually we ignore that, right? But it's telling us there's a huge problem. This formula omits adjacent cells. Let me press F2 and you'll see that it is not the total at all. It only got the last 13 cells. And why? Well, yesterday when I recorded the macro, that particular data set only had 13 rows, and even though I had relative references turned on, the AUTOSUM button does not get recorded correctly by Microsoft. How frustrating is that? Well, is there a solution to this? Is there some way to write a formula that's going to say, look, we always want to go from the row right above us all the way back to row 2 every time, and we could write a formula that would say equal sum of $2 to, in this case, F17. The dollar sign is saying, hey, we always want to start at row 2. Now, we would never actually type this in real life, but that's the key to get the macro recorder to actually record the right code. So, what are we going to do? We're going to close this without saving. File close. Save changes, no. I'll reopen it. All right. We'll record a new macro again. So, I'll record macro. Call it add totals. Control Shift T. Store it in this workbook. Click OK. Now, pay attention, the relative reference button remembers its last setting, so it's currently turned off. So, I'm going to turn that back on. Now, the first thing we need to do is make sure we get to cell A1. Press Control G and do A1. That way, in case someone happened to click another cell before they run the macro. Just like yesterday, we can use N down or Control down arrow to get to the last row. One more to get to the total. And then head over here to column E. Now, this is where I used the AUTOSUM button and got into trouble yesterday. So, the macro recorder doesn't do well with the AUTOSUM button. We're actually going to type a formula here, equals sum of $2 down to E13 today. I'll press Control Enter to enter that formula and stay in the current cell and then use the fill handle to copy it to the right. Okay, now at this point, I want to move back to cell A1, actually back to row A1. I'm going to turn off relative reference to do that and select these cells from A1 to G1. Now I can format those, Control B maybe, and then format column auto fit to make everything fit. And then finally select cell A1. Okay, well, we're done recording. We need to press the stop recording button and we'll go on and test now on Tuesday. Control Shift T. All right, the total showed up in the right spot. That's a good sign. And then when we check, the totals actually worked for all of our data. On Wednesday, I have even fewer records. We'll do Control Shift T again. And sure enough, check to make sure that the totals are grabbing just the right rows. Well, there you have it. The macro recorder can actually work once you master using the relative reference button, and then a few small tricks like the AUTOSUM button tends not to work, but if you write your formula carefully, you can work your way around that. Well, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.